In 2010, I was working at a consulting company, which I actually left because I wanted to study bioinformatics. I got really intrigued by that field because it sounded really exciting to learn more about our human body and environments by coding or like by writing programs. Over a decade later, I'm still mind blown by the rapid changes of that field. Like, we have a technological revolution literally every 1 or 2 years. One word, bioinformatics. There's also, people say computational biology, but that's two words, right? Mm-hmm. Our lab is a bioinformatics and machine learning lab, which tries to organize and extract new knowledge from large biological data sets. Molecular biology is driven by technological changes. For example, reading the genome from a single organism or even whole environments is rapidly getting cheaper and cheaper, much, much faster than our computational resources are growing. So this leads to biologists generating petabytes of publicly available data that we can barely search through and make sense of. So our lab is trying to build the software to analyze these big data sets and to make this software accessible to the biological community. Our lab has built multiple softwares which have already high popularity. For example, MMCX2 is one of these methods that can search protein sequences in protein databases. It was already installed over 270,000 times and is becoming like a standard tool for analyzing sequences in the field, and all the big institutions already start using it, so that's great.
Hello, we are Seoul University Biological Sciences and Biological Research Lab.
Hello, I'm Minghang Li. I'm an undergraduate intern also working at the Bioinformatics and Machine Learning Lab.
같은 연구실의 박사과정 김현빈입니다. 네, 저는 지금 단백질 구조 정보 데이터를 다루고 있고요. 단백질 구조 데이터 내에 원자 정보 데이터를 어떤 식으로 효율적으로 압축할 수 있을지에 대해 연구하고 있습니다. 그 전체 큰 프로젝트는 아마 단백질 스트럭처 얼라이너를 만드는 프로젝트가 될 것 같고요. 저는 그 중에 네, 서브파트를 맡아서 진행하고 있습니다.
Our lab is mostly working on building on fast and reliable tools for analyzing biological big data, and I am currently working on a tool that is used for analyzing huge amount of protein database. It is very highly optimized and highly parallelizable. My part is rather software engineering oriented rather than biological oriented, but I really enjoy the process of understanding the hardware and architecture of the computer and making it very fast and easy to use for biologists.
제가 하고 있는 거는 일단 두 가지가 있는데, 하나는 바이러스 지놈을 이용해서 그 바이러스를 디텍션할 수 있는 DNA 서열을 만드는 작업을 하고 있고요. 또 하나는 알려진 종의 유전 정보를 기반으로 해서 비교적 알려지지 않은 종의 유전자를 예측하는 그런 프로젝트를 하고 있습니다. 바이러스 같은 경우에는 인플루엔자 바이러스도 했었고, 지금은 코로나 바이러스를 하고 있습니다.
흔히들 센트럴 도그마라고 많이 얘기를 하는 DNA, RNA에서 프로틴으로 오는 전 파트를 연구자들이 어떤 식으로 컴퓨터에 적용해 왔는지, 그리고 그걸 어떻게 다루고 있는지를 직접 경험해 볼 수도 있고, 아직 어떤 부분이 미흡한지를 또 찾아야 돼서, 아직도 이 분야는 초기 분야라고 생각을 하기 때문에 되게 재밌는, 어떻게 보면 탐험해야 될 곳이 많은 연구 분야라고 생각을 하고 있습니다.
I think our lab is open to students with various backgrounds. It would be good if you already know how to code and know a little bit about C++, Python, and familiar with Linux, or any kind of Unix-like system, but it would be okay if you don't know it. You can learn. The most important thing is that you are interested in dealing with biological big data problem.
제가 생각했을 때는 실험을 싫어하시거나 머릿속으로 이론적인 것 좋아하시는 분들, 혹은 꼼꼼한 성격을 가지신 분들이 아마 적성에 맞으실 것 같습니다. 마틴 교수님께서 워낙 뛰어난 소프트웨어 개발자시면서 연구자시기 때문에 어떻게 실제로 툴을 개발할 수 있는지, 그리고 어떻게 그 툴을 이제 뭐 매니지하고 뭐 계속 수정해 나가고 보완해 나갈 수 있는지 많은 도움을 얻을 수 있는 연구실일 것 같습니다.
there's always something you don't expect in the data. So you say that a nucleotide sequence, so you assume there's A, T, G, and C, but then there's sometimes an N, or sometimes there's a lowercase whatever. So, and thinking about all of these possibilities that can go wrong is really important, because at the end, building software that is not just cutting edge and you can show in a plot that something looks nice and you can publish that, but make actually software that's usable for the community requires a lot of like finding these cases that are difficult and fixing them and make the software not crash. I think that makes it really, really hard. And that's actually a lot of time goes into the development of make software usable. So we're working on pathogen detection. So we want to make a universal test from human specimens to figure out what kind of pathogen is in that specimens, to have rapid identification so that maybe the clinicians can change something about it. We currently work on drug discovery and drug development using machine learning and metagenomic data. Metagenomic data is data from using from the environment. So we try to find new proteins in the environment which might have some nice drug effect, hopefully in the human, first in the mouse. And we're also interested in remote homology detection, meaning you have a protein sequence and you want to trace it back in the evolutionary time so that you can find the ancestors maybe across the kingdom, so it might go from bacteria to eukaryotes. Bioinformatics is currently in this epicenter of biology, data science and machine learning. Most of these new algorithms, new machine learning methods are first applied to the biological problems. And on the other side, it's also a field of open science, meaning that people share their results very fast and the code is available and makes it really easy for researchers to use. It's really barely the case that you find a method where you cannot find the source code available for it. I think that makes it really, really attractive, and also it improves the velocity of the research. So it becomes faster and faster and faster. So I think you should join our lab if you're interested in analyzing complex data, or if you want to learn how to build fast and scalable and usable software that biologists can use to analyze these complex data.